Notion have had a busy week this week. They've introduced something in databases allowing you to create recurring items. This is perfect for tasks, journals, and also meetings. Today, I'm going to quickly summarize a few of the ways that you can start using it. So if you're new here, welcome. My name is Francesco D'Alessio. We run Keep Productive. So if you're new here, please do subscribe. We cover Notion and plenty of other productivity tools. And we have a Notion newsletter. We've been running it for 4 or 5 years now. However, we've just launched it again, sort of re-brought it back. Over 4,500 people are members. You can link to it in the description below. So Notion databases is an exciting update because this has been something a lot of people have been waiting on for a long time. The first addition or way that you can use Notion databases with the recurring function is with tasks. A lot of people have been waiting for recurring tasks and even hacking ways to do it in the past. However, this is now possible. If you create a new database template that recurs, you can set it up so it recurs however you best wish it to. And this is perfect because you could set up a recurring item to come up weekly, or you could set it to come up daily. This is perfect for creating habitual-based tasks. If you're looking to create it for a habit tracker and you want to be able to complete the items on it, this is perfect for that. But it's not only perfect for that, but also if you do something routinely on, say, a Tuesday or a Wednesday that you and your team are working on, you can set that up. Now, the second demonstration of this being used is with meetings. If you and your team have a weekly stand-up or a monthly meeting with one-to-ones, then you can have this reoccurring and have the database template pop up with the meeting context and information. This is perfect for saving yourself a bit of time instead of routinely creating stuff and producing actions after it. This will save you a lot of time and definitely help you out when one-to-one meetings and meetings are a thing. So finally, journaling is obviously something that this naturally lends itself to. You could have a daily journal that disappears based on when you create it and when it's been completed. This is a really interesting addition and will save you time even just pressing new and getting started, and it'll pop up a little bit sort of like scheduling it or organizing it to be created every single day as a routine. This is a great addition, and these are just three of the ways that you can use the recurring function in databases inside Notion. Thank you so much for stopping by, folks. As I said, we're pushing subscribers, so if you please do subscribe to this today, that'd be amazing. And if you do enjoy this video, hit the like button. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio. Thank you very much for watching today's video. If you're interested in checking out some more, you'll find them here. And also you can subscribe to as well. It'd be great to have you here to optimize your tool. And if you're interested in our new email newsletters or our Bento application, or even Toolfinder, which is a new tool that we've created to help you find the perfect productivity tool, you can find it linked in the description.